Hello, my name is Nurse Pauline RN. The title of my video today is on oxygenation. I will tell you only what's needed for your examination. Ventilation is a process of moving gases in and out of the lungs. Oxygen must be ordered by the doctor. If a patient needs oxygen, if there's no order, apply the oxygen to the patient, call the doctor, have the doctor give you an order for oxygen. Humidified oxygen is for patients with oxygen 5 liters or greater. If a patient's oxygen is low, first you check the flow meter on the wall to make sure it's turned on. Second, check the probe on your patient's finger. Is your patient wearing artificial fingernails? Is your patient wearing nail polish? Are the fingers cold? If the fingers are cold and your oxygen is not recording adequately, just remove the probe or the pulse oximeter from the finger, apply it to the ears or the forehead or the toes. Oxygen monitoring devices at the bedside is ordered by the doctor. The oxygen devices at the bedside enables the nurse to monitor our patient's oxygen at the bedside and out of the room. If the nurse is at the nursing station, she can be able to see the oxygen level of her patient even though she's not at the bedside. Patients who are on bed rest, patients who are total care, not able to move or turn themselves, should be turned and repositioned every 2 hours. While they are in bed, patients who are total care, bed rest, patients who are post-operative patients, they should be wearing their SCD as ordered by the doctor, sequential compression stockings. Make sure the machine is turned on. If the patient has the stockings on and the machine is not turned on, it does not benefit the patients. Patients complaining of pain in their legs, redness, communicate with the doctor that patient has pain, redness in their extremities. The doctor will order a Doppler of the lower extremities. SCDs must be, that machine must be turned on. Patients who are not on bed rest should be sitting in a chair for breakfast. Try to get them up before breakfast. Patients who are not on complete bed rest should be ambulating the hallway times a day. Doctor orders incentive spirometers for patients. These patients should be using their incentive spirometers 10 times over the hour, 10 times for 1 hour. They will breathe into the incentive spirometers as if they were sucking a straw. Patients who are wheezing, administer their inhalers routinely or PRN. If there is no order for inhalers like albuterol, notify the doctor. Check their oxygen. If they are not on oxygen, if their oxygen level is low, put them on the oxygen. Call the doctor for an order and ask the doctor to order inhalers or breathing treatments for these patients. Albuterol inhalers are administered by a respiratory therapist, not a registered nurse. Patients with COPD, asthma, we should teach these patients to be sitting upright in bed. We should teach check these patients' oxygen, make sure they are not in any distress. Patients on asthma or COPD, 88% on room air may be adequate for these patients. Make sure they are not showing any respiratory distress. Patients who are cardiac patients, we should not encourage these patients to have the valve self maneuver. Patients should be on stool softeners. These patients should not be bearing down to have a bowel movement. We should order pain medications for patients' PRN to assist them with their breathing. Patient with a non-rebreather mask. Non-rebreather mask allows your patients to receive oxygen at a higher concentration on assisted 10 liters to 15 liters, not administer humidified oxygen to patients who are on a non-rebreather mask. Teach patients COPD asthma to breathe with pursed lips, diaphragmatic breathing. Teach patients to breathe in a brown paper bag, which makes breathing easier. This is a test question. Teach COPD patients the orthopneic position, sitting upright and leaning over a table to breathe. Patients who are coughing, administer cough medicines, PRN. Call the doctor, get an order, PRN cough medication. Cough medications are Teslin pearls, Robitussin for cough. Patient with difficulty breathing, you will see them having shortness of breath, cyanosis, blueness of the skin, confusion because their oxygen is low. When a patient is confused, first check for apoxia, low oxygen in the brain. Bradypnea is less than 12 breaths per minute. Tachapnea is greater than 20 respiration breaths a minute. Kussmaul respiration is a type of hyperventilation, labored breathing, deep breathing, acidosis. This is an emergency. Notify the doctor, call for help. Patients with shine strokes, abnormal respiration, deeper breathing. These patients, sometimes they breathe faster. Temporarily apnea, absence of breathing. These are seen in your hospice patients or patients who are dying. In CPR, we do CAB, circulation, airway, breathing. Heimlich maneuver, this is done for patients who are choking, abdominal thrust, ineffective airway clearance. teach patients and families not to smoke while they are in the hospital or even home. Some patients use oxygen while they are home. Perform mouth care on unconscious patients. While performing mouth care, these patients should be lying on the side. Prevent tongue obstruction in unconscious patients. Prevent obstruction of the airway. Patients with sleep apnea, the doctor will order a CPAP machine. Patients with low level oxygen or impaired gas exchange, the doctor will order ABG, arterial blood gas. The blood will be drawn by the respiratory therapy from the radial artery. ABG detect measures of oxygen and CO2 in the blood. Early sign of hypoxemia is nasal flaring using accessory muscles. Late signs of hypoxemia is cyanosis. Hemoptysis is blood in sputum. Those patients who are coughing, patients with TB will do 3 consecutive days of sputum specimens for patients with TB to rule out TB. Patients with TB will monitor their sputum, will take their sputum specimen early in the morning, as soon as they wake up. If a patient's HNH is low, may need blood transfusion, please check their oxygen. Hemoglobin transports oxygen to the tissues and cells. Pneumothorax is air in the pleural space. Patients who smoke cigarettes, nicotine causes cardiopulmonary diseases and lung cancer. Teach your patients about secondhand smoking, especially smoking around children. Offer pamphlets. Order smoking cessation education. Teach patients the necessity of having carbon dioxide detector in the homes. Teach patients the necessity of having smoke detectors in the house. If patients are too weak to clear their airway, maybe coughing, these patients should be suctioned. In order to suction your patients, you should hyperventilate them first. Turn the oxygen up and you suction for 10 seconds. Turn the oxygen up, suction for 10 seconds. Patients who have signs and symptoms of pulmonary edema is pink frothy sputum. Cardinal sign of pulmonary edema is pink frothy sputum. Coughing, anxiety, restlessness, and you will see this while you're in the hospital with your patients. Restlessness, anxiety, pink frothy sputum. Teach patients to decrease exposure to noxious fumes in the workplace and home. teach patients to avoid occupational hazards, avoid asbestos, avoid dust, use protective gears, use goggles and masks while they're in the workplace. Use face shields. CDC recommends that all elderlies over the age of 65 should have a pneumonia vaccination. Patients who are in bed, total care, the Vinodines may be on, but the machines at the bedside to pump that compression stock in is not turned on. Patients on bed rest, they're not out of bed walking. These patients will show signs and symptoms of pulmonary embolus. We're not talking about pain in the legs right now. We're not talking about redness or swelling in the legs. We're talking about patients with respiratory signs of pulmonary embolus. Signs are shortness of breath, chest pain. I've seen this in the workplace. Your patient is a post-op patient, refuse to get up. I've seen this. If you have a post-op patient and they refuse to get out of bed at 9 o'clock, call the doctor. The doctor will come to the bedside and communicate the importance to this patient to get up out of bed. I've seen this gone down. Patients call, patient was short of breath, chest pain, that's a Mets call. This patient was having sign of pulmonary embolus, tachycardia. We will call the Mets team. Make sure patients have sequential stockings, prevents pulmonary embolus, prevents chest pain. Please hit your like button. It's very important to hit the like button. YouTube would like to see that people are hitting the like buttons. Please subscribe to my channel. If you have not subscribed, please share my videos to your families, friends, and classmates. Please comment below. Thanks to all. Have a blessed day. I wish you good luck in your examinations. Thank you.